What is up, everybody? Golden Holden here today, and today we are going to be showing off how to plate copper in our ProLab and the process that you go through to do so. So copper is very similar to brass and silver, so this process will be pretty similar for those types of metals as well. So let's get right into it. All right, to start off our process, we're going to be using our Electroclean, and it is going to be at 130 degrees Fahrenheit, and we're going to be plating it for about a minute at 5 volts. So the thing with copper and Electroclean is the stuff in Electroclean breaks down a lot faster when you're plating copper. Rather, if you were to plate nickel, it wouldn't break down as fast and it wouldn't need to be replaced as quickly. So just a little note about Electroclean, that does happen when you are plating copper in it. So, all right, so now this is done, we are going to rinse off our pieces and we will go into our surface activator after this is rinsed off well. All right, now we are going to be going into our surface activator, and our surface activator is at the same voltage as our Electroclean, that 5 volts, and it is gonna be at room temperature, and we're only gonna activate our pieces for about 15, 20 seconds, and they should be good. All right, now that we got those all activated, we will rinse them off good, and we'll go on to the next step. Our next step is now nickel, and our nickel is going to be at 130 degrees. We're going to be plating these for about 2 minutes or more, it depends. And we're going to be at 2.3 volts. So a little information about the nickel is we need a diffusion barrier on these copper pieces, or because brass and silver are similar, we're going to need a diffusion barrier on those as well, and nickel is a great option for creating that diffusion barrier. So what a diffusion barrier does is it helps prevent the copper, brass, or silver from diffusing through the gold. So it's creating a barrier so these metals can't leak, or not leak, but just diffuse through the gold, because gold is very porous. So we're going to just be applying a nickel barrier on them, and that will help prevent that. All right, our 2 minutes is now up, and we'll take our pieces out, and you can see that they're looking pretty good. We have that nickel on them. We'll rinse them off. We need to rinse them off good, and then we're gonna go into our gold. So now we're going to be plating these parts in our gold, and our gold is actually gonna be at 100 degrees Fahrenheit, and we're gonna be plating onto our pieces at 2.3 volts for 2 or more minutes. So gold, if you look at it up close, kind of looks like an orange in how it has all those pores, and that's why metals like copper, brass, and silver pull through or diffuse through gold, because it's very porous. So that is why we need a barrier such as nickel to help prevent that. If a diffusion barrier isn't an option, then you could plate the nickel, or you could plate the gold on a lot thicker, and it will help prevent the metals from pulling through the gold. So yeah, we'll just plate these pieces for 2 or more minutes, and we'll pull them out and look at them. All right, our parts are all done, and we're gonna just take them out. And these look really good. Let me rinse them off so I can show you them. All right, yeah, there's our parts. They're looking really good. So we'll dry them off and take a look at them, and yeah. All right, so here are those parts that we just plated, and they are looking really good, and I'm happy of how they turned out. So plating copper in the ProLab is pretty simple. It's not too hard. You just need to remember that you do need a diffusion barrier because the copper will diffuse through the gold because it is porous. And this applies for brass and silver as well. They will diffuse through the gold if you don't have that diffusion barrier like nickel or palladium. So yeah, just make sure that you have that diffusion barrier and you shouldn't have any problems with your copper, brass, or silver. But if you don't have the diffusion barrier as an option, you can plate the gold on a little thicker and it won't be a problem. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and if you have any questions, please go to our website and ask our tech email. And if you enjoyed this video, please give it a like, and thanks so much for watching.